Hey friends, today I'm taking you through an achievable process to get a job in cybersecurity with zero experience. This video is kindly sponsored by ISC Squared, but more on them a little later on in the video. Okay, today I'm gonna share a step-by-step process, a free certification and exam opportunity, and a completely free resource at the end to make the job hunting process so much easier. If you want to get into the industry, you're going to need a few things. First up, education, some industry knowledge, skills, and of course, a resume, a profile, and a network to help you along with the job hunting journey. Now, to achieve all that with zero experience can be really daunting and overwhelming, but today we're going to break it down and make those steps simpler and make them completely achievable, even for someone that has zero experience in this industry whatsoever. Step one is to start by getting some form of education. And my recommended way in cybersecurity to actually get educated is by getting certified. Getting certified gives you so many benefits. One of the key ones is firstly gaining good overall industry knowledge, and secondly, getting the required credentials that's mainly required by most employers looking for cybersecurity professionals or skilled professionals in the industry. And that brings me to the sponsor of today's video, which is ISC Squared. Because if you are going to get certified, who better to do it with than the world's leading cybersecurity professional organization? ISC Squared is known for the CISSP among many other great certifications, and I have my own personal story about how the CISSP has completely changed my career, which you can definitely check out if you're interested. As part of ISC Squared's commitment to close the global workforce gap, they have launched the initiative called 1 Million Certified in Cybersecurity. With this initiative, they are offering free Certified in Cybersecurity online self-paced training and the exam to the first 1 million people entering the field for the very first time. The Certified in Cybersecurity is an entry-level certification. It's aimed at IT professionals, recent graduates, college students, or anyone looking to change or pivot their career into cybersecurity. You require no previous certifications, no previous work experience. The course is delivered online and covers 5 domains, which are security principles, business continuity and disaster recovery, access control, network security, and security operations. The opportunity is available for all newcomers globally. I've listed the links you need to register, all the steps that you need to take to complete the registration process, and basically everything you need is linked down in the description below. This is big, people. It is completely free and it can get you so much closer to getting your first opportunity in cybersecurity. Definitely take advantage of the opportunity and sign up to get the Certified in Cybersecurity completely free and take the exam. Really important, take the exam and get certified. All right. Before we move on to step two, if you find my content helpful and you find this video valuable, remember to like and hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any future videos. All right, step two is industry knowledge. Getting to know the industry is really important if you wanna be successful in having conversations with potential employers and hiring managers and potential peers into the industry. Now, there are many ways that you can actually gain industry knowledge. The top two for me are definitely via podcasts and newsletters. Now, podcasts are a great way to learn about cybersecurity. Firstly, because you can gain a whole lot of knowledge about the industry and you can find out about the latest threats, the latest cybersecurity events. But secondly, here's a hidden gem with podcasts. With podcasts, you actually are listening to people talk about cybersecurity. And the difference here is that you are actually learning about the industry jargon. So you're learning what people are talking about. You're learning about IOCs, indicators of compromise, threats, TTPs, all of these different terms and acronyms and everything that people talk about in cybersecurity, you're actually hearing in context how it's used. So that is an absolute hidden gem. It is my number one on-the-go method for consuming cybersecurity knowledge and information. I have two of my favorite podcasts. The first one is the Sans Stormcast. So this one is really like, it's an everyday thing. It's 5 minutes to listen to. They update you on the latest news, the latest happenings from the previous day, and really big events that's happening in cybersecurity. And then the second one for me is the CyberWire Daily. So the CyberWire Daily is the podcast where they have also cybersecurity news, but sometimes they have snippets of interviewing different industry professionals, and you can just gain a whole lot of knowledge by listening to the CyberWire Daily. So definitely subscribe to those two podcasts and consume as much information as you can on the go. And then second part to this is the newsletters. So from a newsletter perspective, this of course gives you brief bits of information that you need into knowledge into cybersecurity, into knowing about the latest breaches and the latest cybersecurity events and information and any new controls and any new trends that people are talking about in cybersecurity, which significantly helps you out during the interview process to have kind of this real world up-to-date knowledge. And for me, the two newsletters that I highly recommend you subscribe to is the Hacker News. Just so much contextual cybersecurity information inside of this newsletter, definitely a must subscribe. And then Krebs on Security. So this is by the renowned cybersecurity journalist, Brian Krebs, and he has this newsletter and basically sharing all of the cybersecurity information. But there's also an interesting aspect to this, that there are usually freebies in the newsletters of tools that you should try and check out, or even recommendations of networking events and people who you can network with, which of course helps you significantly to build your network, which is a step that we are talking about later on in the video. Okay, on to step three. Step three is gaining the skills. Now, in this video, I am not going into depth about gaining skills, simply because I have done multiple videos about how you can gain cybersecurity skills, different platforms that you can use, free platforms, platforms that really gives you the abilities to do hands-on practice for multiple different roles. So I've shared some for ethical hackers, I've shared some for security analysts, I've just shared a whole bunch of platforms on my channel already. I will link the beginner playlist down below so you can go and check it out and find out which platform may be the right one for you. One thing I will say is that you need to make sure that you actually are focused on getting the basic knowledge done. Now, the basic skills are really, really important in cybersecurity, and most people, there's so much information to consume, and most people tend to skim over the basics and just brush over them really quickly to move on to different things. However, the basics are really what carries you throughout your career. So it doesn't matter, it might change to artificial intelligence or cloud computing or machine learning or different advancements in technology. However, you still need to know how things work, what the ability of compromise is in different systems, how networks are configured together, etc. Those are all the basics. And I have an entire video speaking about the basics, which I will link down below as well. Definitely go and check it out if you're looking to really advance in the skills part of trying to get your first job into cybersecurity. For step four, you are going to need a CV or resume, you're going to need a profile, ideally a LinkedIn profile, and you're going to need to start building your network. Network meaning a network of professionals that you are connected with on a particular platform, and you can either share or gain knowledge from these different individuals and different professionals. All right, it's freebie time. Now, if you are studying in cybersecurity and you're looking to basically get your first job into the industry, and you're just starting a brand new resume from scratch as a student, maybe you're just finding your first job, I have a completely free resume template for you. I've linked it down below. You can use this resume template. It's got information bits that you can just use and fill it in. And basically, this template will help you to structure your very first resume, contextual, of course, to cybersecurity. And basically, it will help you to get your foot in the door with starting to apply for cybersecurity jobs. If you are a professional that's already in the industry, you maybe have a job or you have another job and you're looking to pivot into cybersecurity, then you don't necessarily have to have a beginner resume or start from scratch with your resume. You just need to update your resume and make it more applicable to cybersecurity. Then I highly recommend that you check out this free platform, which is called resumeworded.com. So you're just going to go to resumeworded.com. It's an AI-based platform and tool. This tool is really phenomenal. In the tool, basically, you have the option to select like what type of job or roles you are applying for, and then it can basically go and analyze your resume for that and analyze your LinkedIn profile, etc. Now, caveat here, if you are uploading your resume there, make sure that you actually X out any personal information or something like that. Anything that's not in the public domain, you should X it out. And then, but the tool will really go through this and give you an up to scratch and really great resume to work from. And now you can use this resume to basically just enhance it and then start your job application process from there. Let's do a quick recap of this video. Step one, get educated. Remember to check out the free certified in cybersecurity training and exam by ISC Squared and get certified, people. Take advantage of it, get certified. Step two is getting your industry knowledge. Go back and check out the resources that are recommended from a podcast and newsletter perspective and make sure that you subscribe to those and you start getting your industry knowledge. Step three is the skills. Go and check out my beginner playlist or the basics that you need in cybersecurity to gain the skills that you need. And step four is to update or construct your resume and start building a LinkedIn profile for yourself. Resume template down below or go to resumeworded.com. All right, friends, that is it for this video. I am Venetia, your cybersecurity bestie. Thank you so much for watching. Remember to subscribe if you find this content helpful and if you want to see any more cybersecurity videos. And if you are starting the job hunting process and you're struggling in the process, you should definitely check out this video next, where I basically tell you how to apply for a job in cybersecurity. Catch you next time, friends. Bye.